Here we are at the Elkhart Park trailhead on the west side of the Wind River Range near Pinedale, Wyoming. About to set out on a 3-day backpacking trip. It's 10:30 a.m. on July 13th, and it's about 67 degrees.
About WhatsApp.
Got our first sight of the peaks now in this little meadow. Pretty exciting. There's Fremont Peak on the far right. Mount Sacajawea right in the middle. Pretty nice lunch spot. Got a good look at the full range. Sacajawea, Mount Helen, Mount Warren, Mount Woodrow Wilson. Thank you. Seneca Lake that way. There's our trail down there. See it down by the lake? It goes up there. Nice view of Fremont Peak right there. There's Hobbs Lake. There's fish jumping up in this little outlet stream. Sam's filling water bottles. I'll explain what our plan is for today. We started here at Elkhart Park, drove up to the parking lot, been hiking along this Pole Creek Trail, went up to this photographer's point, and that's where we ate lunch. Then we're coming around here, passed by Barber Lake and Hobbs Lake. We're right at the top of Hobbs Lake filling up water. Then we'll continue on up by Seneca Lake, Little Seneca Lake, and we'll probably camp somewhere around Island Lake up here. So that's our plan for today. Thank you. Starting in on the CDT trail. That's a through hike from Mexico to Canada. A ton of Indian paintbrush in this field here. It's pretty awesome. On tonight's menu, the main entree of chicken ramen. For dessert, fruit cup, and a spectacular view. There's a couple other campers down there, camping next to Island Lake. All right, we're setting off day two. I'm gonna leave our campsite here. Because this is an out and back trail, so we'll just come back to this campsite. And yeah, should be another good day. Fill up on water right here. There's Fremont sticking out right between those mountains. Fremont Peak. Titcomb Basin's right on the other side. That's what we just came up. It's beautiful. That there is the ridge up to Fremont Mountain. If we were gonna do that, but we're not. It's a little too late in the day for that. We gotta get back to camp. Pretty cool though. Well, we just made it to the top of the Fremont Saddle, looking back at Indian Basin. where we came from. Now we've got a pretty sweet view of Titcomb Basin and Titcomb Lakes. It's pretty awesome. This is the farthest we're gonna get from the parking lot. I'm gonna point the camera where I think we came from. Way out there somewhere in the haze. Came quite a ways so far. Time to head down. Pretty cool. There's like this little dense patch of flowers. Pretty cool. Come down a long ways already. See, just over those jagged peaks covered in snow, I think that's Gannett Peak, which is pretty cool to be able to see it from here. That's the tallest peak in Wyoming. Doing a little class 3 route finding. It's pretty fun. Here's what we're climbing down. We're almost to the bottom. Well, we pretty much made it down to the lake level. Coming down off the Fremont saddle up there. It's kind of crazy. There's some class 3 stuff in there, but it's pretty fun route finding. All right, we're down amongst the lakes in Titcomb Basin. That's looking towards where we're going. Fremont Peak. Here's the saddle. Came down this.
All right, back on a real trail. First time in quite a while. Back to the Indian Pass Junction. Made it back to our little pond where we're gonna eat supper. Call it a night. Tonight we're having tikka vegetables. I'll just take a quick look at the map again, show you where we went today. We started here at our Island Lake campsite, came down around all the way to this junction here for Indian Pass, and we actually went into Indian Basin, which is this big area here. There's Fremont Peak, and the trail is pretty faint all along in this basin area by all the lakes, but we found it kind of comes and goes, and you see it every once in a while, but then you actually do get off the established trail to get up to the pass, up to the saddle of Fremont Peak. So that's where we went up, and it's kind of drawn in here on this map. So we got up here on the saddle and then came down, and this was the real class 3 stuff, coming down into Titcomb Basin, which is here, and then we skirted along Mistake Lake from the pass, and then got up around this hill here and got back on the trail, and then we just made our way back along the Titcomb Basin trail, and then back to our campsite near Island Lake. So yeah, that's what we did today, and tomorrow we'll just make our way back that same trail that we came in on and call it a trip. Does that feel pretty good?
Yeah.
So ends another good day. Not a bad view from the tent. All right, back on the trail, heading back to the parking lot. It's about 9:30 in the morning. Another good day.
Well, now that we're heading back, I don't know how much video I'll shoot, since it's all territory we've already covered before, but maybe there'll be some new inspiring angle to look at. Back to the big Seneca Lake, sparkling in the morning sun.
Pretty nice seeing Seneca Lake in the sunlight now. That's our trail, just came up.
Back to Barber Lake.
Oh wow, we're already in the junction.
Yeah.
Been walking through a lot of fallen down trees because last year we were told that there was a big, pretty rare storm that came through and had 100 mile an hour winds. So the Forest Service has come in here and cleared all these trees off the trail, which is really nice, and they did it without chainsaws. They're not allowed to use chainsaws in the wildlife area or wilderness area. So, thanks to the Forest Service, we haven't stepped over a single tree. Starting to sprinkle on us a little bit. About less than an hour to the parking lot. I see something in the trees.
We'll pull boards and slaws with. Started down the road. Started down the road. Scotty had started down the road. Going out in this world, well, God only knows. And that'll be the way to get along.
We'll pull boards,
all the
end.
I believe I ride, believe I go back home, believe I go back.